At the end of the Second World War, technological development spurred by that conflict accelerated scientific breakthroughs. One of APL's first post-war innovations was to turn a weapon of war into a vehicle for research and exploration. In 1946, research teams at the White Sands Proving Ground began using captured Nazi V-2 rockets to probe the outer reaches of the atmosphere and space. Two members of the lab's high-altitude research team, J. Allen Hynek and Clyde Holliday, realized that a camera mounted to the rocket would be able to take scientifically valuable and remarkable images from high altitude. Holliday modified a 35mm DeVry movie camera to withstand the shock of launch and landing impact. He designed a special magazine to protect the film, driven by a 24-volt electric motor taken from the computer of a B-29 machine gun director system. The entire camera was then placed in a duraluminum box, 3/8 of an inch thick, with only the lens protruding. For the curious, the film was Eastman Super XX, exposed at 4 frames per second. The aperture was set at 5.6 and the shutter speed 1/50th of a second. On October 24, 1946, the V-2 carrying Holliday's special camera roared 65 miles into the New Mexico sky. Just a few minutes later, its fuel expended, the rocket fell to Earth, sending the camera plummeting freely downward at some 500 feet per second. It took until the next day to recover the camera. The lens and batteries were smashed off, but the armored film magazine inside survived. The grainy black and white images within, the first ever taken of our planet from space, became a global phenomenon. Never before had human beings seen their world from this height. The curvature of the Earth was clearly visible, as were thick clouds over the American West. Writing in National Geographic about his images, Holliday predicted future uses for this innovation. Quote, "Results of these tests now are pointing to a time when cameras may be mounted on guided missiles for scouting enemy territory in war, mapping inaccessible regions of the Earth in peacetime, and even photographing cloud formations, storm fronts, and overcast areas over an entire continent in a few hours." The following years would bring many more impressive images and film. In 1948, APL produced a pamphlet called So, Columbus Was Right, that contained clips from more than 1,000 publications that covered the Earth picture. Holliday and Hynek showed us how science can be rewarding and inspiring, using what had once been a tool of terror to give us a never-before-seen view of our world.